wind has an element of the unknown, the unpredictable, plus a sense of great power and great gentleness. Therefore, the wind has always been a symbol of the movements of life, of the human spirit, and especially a symbol of the Holy Spirit. So we sing. The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind. In this folk mass, the winds of God symbolize, first, the hardships of life, which can either block our progress or sail us forward, as in the opening hymn, Michael, Row Your Boat. Yes, and the winds of God are the deep desires of our hearts, expressed in the plaintive notes of the three prayers, Lord, have mercy upon us, Kumbaya, which means come by here, and the Hebrew anthem, Avinu Malkeinu. The winds are the great movements of God's Spirit in nature and in history, preeminently in Christ, as expressed in the Creed. The wind is also the marvelous peace of God, which shakes us up rather thoroughly in the sermon sung by the choir. Then, too, the winds of God are the joys, the faith, and the dedication which we express in the swinging melodies of He's Got the Whole World in His Hands, the Sanctus, and the Lord's Prayer. As the service moves towards its conclusion, there blows yet another wind from God, the deep feeling of brotherhood found in the Negro tune and in the words of In Christ there is no East or West. The last hymn is Blowing in the Wind, our theme. And there in Bob Dylan's song, the wind of God is the spirit that enters into the tensions of men, suffering, protesting, yet confident. This is a service of worship often called the Lord's Supper, and the challenge of every service of Holy Communion is the experience of dynamic, loving, habitual communion between God's Spirit and ours, the most prevailing of winds. These, then, are a few of the meanings of our symbolism. And in all of these ways, we believe. The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind.
Oh, crucify all soldiers under Pontius Pilate.
He suffered and died.
And the third day he rose again according to the scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of our Father, and he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost,
the Lord and Giver of
life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son
together is worshipped
and glorified,
spake by the prophets.
And I believe one Catholic,
Apostolic Church.
I acknowledge one baptism
for the remission of sins,
and I look for the resurrection
of the
dead and the life of the world to come.
abide, my Lord. Oh, sometimes it causes me to crucified my Lord. Were you there when they nailed him to the tree? Sometimes it causes me to tremble. When they nailed him to the tree. When My